The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 215 pounds, DVS, Whitney Rust.
There are people who have not taken kindly to this guy's entry into sports entertainment and say he should stick to movies on demand.
This guy's a risk taker who never shied away from doing his own stunts, but he's bound to find out that bad things happen when you step into other people's worlds.
An excellent high flyer carrying on the Mysterio name. This is going to be good.
And his opponent from San Diego, California, weighing in at 200 pounds, Dominic Mysterio.
Dominic and his dad, Ray, the first ever father and son tag team champions in the history of WWE.
Think about this. In his rookie year in WWE, Dominic Mysterio earned victories over the likes of Chad Gable, Robert Roode, even King Corbin.
The road to the King of the Ring crown begins tonight with Dominic Mysterio facing off against a hungry SmackDown superstar looking to make a serious run at the throne.
Dominic has been called one of WWE's most promising young princes, but his opponent will be looking to make sure that's as royal as Rey's son gets.
Him up, boom, knock him down, ouch. Boom. Kick. That kick will stop me in your tracks. The damage he's taken is starting to pile up. Sure, he's popping himself up, but he's also giving his opponent a chance to recover. Raw drop kick. And Dominic is failing to offer any resistance here.
Dominic now is going to have to dig down deep.
Kick right to the back of the leg.
And misses on the springboard.
Dominic was ready for that.
Set him up for the side rushing leg sweep. He catches Dominic with a counter. Oh, just turned that around. Ah, what a returning fire.
Big ball.
On a tilt away.
Off the shoulders.
A backbreaker. And a gut buster.
Here Whitney Rust.
What an emphatic victory, guys. No contest.
This is what you get when you have complete confidence and control of the situation.
Here's your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney Rust. Here is your winner, DVS, Whitney. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 215 pounds, DVS, Whitney Rust.
Don't forget that while this competitor was trying to carve out a career in Hollywood, he was also a member of the WWE Universe, watching Raw, SmackDown, and NXT every week.
That familiarity with WWE has certainly given him an advantage transitioning from entertainment to sports entertainment.
A competitor with his share of detractors, but he wants to prove them all wrong here tonight. Stand up, Saxton. We are in the presence of true Nigerian royalty.
Or obnoxious royalty.
And his opponent from Benue State, Nigeria, weighing in at 241 pounds, Apollo Crews.
This is a man who realized he's no longer just happy to be in WWE, and Apollo is set to show why he is descended of royal ancestry.
Rubbing it in the face of the entire WWE universe every step of the way.
We are seeing the best version of Apollo yet. I don't necessarily agree with his tactics, but he has never been better in the ring.
The agility, the power, the ruthlessness. Apollo has truly evolved into a difficult opponent for anyone to overcome.
The King of the Ring tournament kicks off with two remarkable superstars looking to officially begin the long climb to the WWE throne.
It might only be a first-round match, but both of these superstars know just how much a King of the Ring crown could change their careers forever, and one loss could derail that entire quest.
No pressure. Into the turnbuckle.
Uh-oh, not a good place to be. And it follows it up with a big one in the face.
Oh, man. Kick to the face.
Springboard. Phoenix splash.
You gotta be kidding me.
Cruz's resolve might be wavering here.
Some flaws in Cruz's game plan are being exposed. Apollo fends that off.
Uh-oh, this is... And will this be it? He's on the ropes. The official sees it and waves off the pin. Lined him up. Boom! Knocked him down. Ouch. Snapmare could set something else up.
This is an incessant attack being brought to him.
Yeah, the defects in this game are launching.
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asking for more.
First one missed, second one didn't.
Effective. He may be in a bad way here.
Yeah, but you can't count anyone out yet. This match could still go either way.
Really just laying it in.
And now Apollo is being mad.
Uh-oh. Look at this. Feeling like it's over for Apollo. Cruz's resolve might be wavering here.
Yeah, Apollo needs to reassess his strategy.
Hit the ropes.
Ooh, what a knee strike.
Ooh, harsh kick. And Apollo Cruz reverses it.
Apollo's going to look to press on the advantage.
Could be a change of fortunes for Cruz.
Able to reverse that one.
Huge boot.
Just mounted with punches.
And right. Apollo Cruz has been busted open.
His offense is on point right now.
Nothing is going to stop him now.
Great reversal. Rocket drop kick.
Ooh.
Suplex! Oh, what a knee strike! Both wrists captured it.
Cruz's resolve might be wavering here.
Some flaws in Cruz's game plan.
Uh-oh. Look at this! Results of this battle plain to see on their face, at least they can say they won the match.
I don't know if I'd say the battle scars were worth it, Cole, but I will say the one who did it to them isn't the one celebrating right now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 215 pounds, Devious Whitney Rust.
He may have started his career in Hollywood, but grew up in a household where Throwback Thursdays meant watching his parents' WWE VHS tapes.
Hey, it's great to grow up a fan, but when you play rough, you get hurt. One wrong move here, and his night's over.
One of the best pure wrestlers in WWE.
And guys, an original bro.
And his opponent, representing RK-Bro from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 216 pounds, Riddle.
Seems like everybody's got an opinion about Riddle, whose laid-back style has earned plenty of fans and detractors.
Welcome to the semifinals of one of the most iconic tournaments in all of sports entertainment, the King of the Ring. We have Riddle taking on a superstar who's starting to pick up some real momentum.
That's right, Michael, and momentum's the name of the game in a tournament like this.
Especially when the semifinals and finals are scheduled to happen on the same night. It's anyone's crown at this point.
Great job anticipating Riddle.
Just mounted with punches. And not, oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
He switches it back around.
Ooh, well measured.
Saw that one coming.
And landing with the double axe handle.
Bang!
Oh, what for?
Oh, he knew what was coming. Gut-wrench suplex.
Top rope, here we go.
Rock drop kick.
The stomp in every single part of his body.
Riddle turns that around.
Oh, hold on. Is he thinking of the submission here?
The break.
He did not want to be caught up in that submission any longer.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
Getting back into the ring.
Drop kick.
Oh, he retaliates.
Oh, man.
Putting the shoulder in jeopardy there.
He's looking a little off balance. See here. Uh-oh. Spiking DDT.
Cross the shoulders.
Riddle's almost solid. That was nasty.
His defenses have fallen, and soon he may too.
Not what you want to see by any means.
And he had Riddle scouted.
Yeah, but he needs to maintain some offense to fully get back in this one.
And a drop kick.
Picture perfect.
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
He's taking a moment to feel the crowd, but he better focus on the opposition. Stop gloating and put your attention back to the match. He is efficient and dangerous with his offense thus far.
This is what he feeds off of.
Knew what was coming there.
Stop to finish it off.
Oh, God.
reality.
Great awareness from Riddle.
Excellent opportunity for Riddle to shift the momentum.
Maybe he's found a new source of aggression to battle back with.
Boom! What a wear down the opponent.
And he keeps his focus on an attack to that area.
Okay, already, we get it. Stop looking for adulation from the crowd and get back into the fight. This is the type of victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
The reward definitely seems greater than the risk right about now, but we'll see how they feel once they get back to the locker room and hit the showers.
I know you just won your match, so I'm not sure if you've heard the latest on Big E and Paragon.
What's going on?
Well, after Big E beat Paragon, they got into a fight backstage, and E was injured. He can't compete tonight or anytime soon.
That's awful, but not surprised with Paragon involved. Am I going to face him now?
No, that wouldn't be fair. I did have someone volunteer to fill in. They're a future Hall of Famer, but they've never been King of the Ring. But this wouldn't be fair either, since they'd be completely rested.
I don't want to be handed this crown on a technicality. I want to earn it in the ring. So I don't care who it's against or how rested they are. I'll do it.
All right. Later tonight in the King of the Ring finals, you're going to face the Viper, Randy Orton. Good luck.
The most lethal superstar in the history of WWE, the Apex Predator. The Viper is here.
And his opponent, representing RK Bro, from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, the Viper, Randy Orton.
What a dramatic turn of events. A fresh Randy Orton is in the King of the Ring finals, facing the superstar coming off a brutal semifinal match earlier tonight against Riddle. I think it's fair to say nobody saw this coming.
I'll tell you who definitely didn't see it coming. Randy Orton's opponent.
No, he can't like it either. Orton's one of the most decorated superstars in WWE history, but he's never been King of the Ring. I think that changes tonight.
Yeah. Just launched. Missed timing with that springboard.
Stomping. Ouch. Randy Orton gets him back. He deflects it right back.
Great job refocusing to reverse that.
Came in.
Oh, unbelievable.
Guys, I have a feeling someone is about to get their chest caved in.
I think it's happening.
Good grief.
The Viper is facing.
There's the twist. Cross body. Ouch.
That is reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well.
The Viper in a tight spot.
That just put down the Viper.
Uh-oh, he's searching for something.
Settling in the kendo stick. No good can come from this.
The WWE Universe is pouring more fuel on his fire right now.
Counters the Viper's attack.
Good chance for him to regain his wits.
Cross the shoulders. A backbreaker.
Finish it off.
Springboard. Field splash.
You gotta be kidding me.
Right to the gut.
Both wrists captured it.
That was nasty. Oh, knee smashing the face. Can Orton withstand this attack?
This can't be how Randy Orton envisioned this match going.
The close of this match is just ahead.
Maybe just stay down, man. You've done enough.
Randy Orton is slipping, but he still might have an RKO in his back pocket.
Hard right hand. What are we going to see here?
Uh-oh. Spiking DDT.
Orton gets the better there.
Orton's finally able to slow all those incoming attacks.
Orton hoping to start a rush of his own now.
Look at this.
Going right after the neck.
Neck breaker.
This right here is vintage Randy Orton stomp.
Orton picking his spot.
The Viper's lined up his play. We know